हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद अनदर मेथड ऑफ कॉस्टिंग विच इज कॉल्ड प्रोसेस कॉस्टिंग. यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द इंडस्ट्रीज वेयर दिस टाइप ऑफ मेथड इज एप्लीकेबल. फर्दर आई विल एलैबोरेट ऑन कंसेप्ट ऑफ लॉसेस एंड गेन्स, नॉर्मल लॉस, एबनॉर्मल लॉस, एबनॉर्मल गेन, their treatment, their journal entries, everything which is to be applied in process costing. So today is a day of concepts. We will learn lots of things related to this process costing. So you can make a heading along with me: process costing. Process costing is applicable in industries where the basic input or raw material passes through more than one process before being converted into finished output. So I put a raw material and apply on that more cost in process 1. The output of that process is not completed output. It goes to process 2, maybe process 3, maybe more processes, and then it becomes finished output. At least two processes must be there, only then we can apply process costing. Now, what is the objective of making process accounts? What I am going to tell you, we prepare a separate process account for each process, for process 1, for process 2, for process 3. Separate process account will be created. What is the objective of making different process accounts for each process? The main objective is to determine cost per unit at the end of each process which is termed as valued cost per unit. For each process, I shall be computing cost per unit, which is valued cost per unit. There is no objective of determining profit here. The process accounts do not intend to calculate profits. In fact, in process account, we don't get any profit or loss. Unlike in contract costing, we created a contract account, balancing figure was notional profit. In cost sheet, if revenue is known, we get the profit as balancing figure. इन ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट वी गेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट, इन P&L अकाउंट वी गेट नेट प्रॉफिट, इन सर्विस कॉस्टिंग ऑल्सो वी क्रिएट कॉस्ट शीट्स वेयर वी गेट प्रॉफिट्स. इन प्रोसेस अकाउंट देयर इज नथिंग लाइक दैट, वी डोंट गेट प्रॉफिट्स. वी विल डू अ स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक लेटर विच इज इंटर प्रोसेस प्रॉफिट, इन दैट सर्टनली विल मेक अ सेपरेट प्रॉफिट कॉलम, बट अदरवाइज इन प्रोसेस अकाउंट वी डोंट गेट द प्रॉफिट एलिमेंट. वी आर ट्राइंग टू डिटर्मिन कॉस्ट पर यूनिट एट द एंड ऑफ ईच प्रोसेस, फ्रॉम फर्स्ट प्रोसेस गोज टू सेकेंड, फ्रॉम सेकेंड प्रोसेस गोज टू थर्ड, फ्रॉम थर्ड प्रोसेस गोज टू फोर्थ, फ्रॉम फोर्थ गोज टू फाइव. वंस इट रीचेज लास्ट प्रोसेस इट बिकम्स फिनिश्ड गुड्स स्टॉक. That is what you are going to study in detail in this process costing. The next concept I elaborate here is meaning of losses and gains. The types of losses, the type of gains you are getting in process costing, I am elaborating in detail. Focus on three terms. Don't look anything on the board. Just look at what I am explaining you. One is normal loss, another is abnormal loss, and third thing is abnormal gain. Try to focus on only normal loss. What is normal loss? Normal loss is something that I am expecting in the process to happen. How do I expect that? It's not on the basis of chemical reaction or science necessarily. It's on the basis of my experience, my past experience. If I teach 100 students in a class, my past result shows 10 will fail. So what I'm saying, I'm expecting in every batch out of 100 students, 10 are expected to fail. This is normal loss percentage based on previous attempts. 4-5 attempts, I get bad students or bad result from institute. Instead of 10, I start getting 18% fail. 18 students out of 100 start getting fail. Now, first few terms, I'll call 8% abnormal loss. But once it becomes a trend, my normal loss percentage as per past experience becomes 18%. Because it's not one odd now, once it is a trend. So based on past experience, whatever percentage you are expecting to lose during the process is termed as normal loss percentage. Anything over and above normal loss is abnormal loss. I am expecting 18% and in a particular batch 23% fail. 5% is abnormal loss. In a particular batch students are more hard working and only 16% fail. Then 2% I have saved is abnormal gain. Anything more than normal loss is abnormal loss. Anything less than a normal loss is abnormal gain. These are three terms that you must remember forever in this chapter. This chapter cannot be done unless you are clear with normal loss, abnormal loss, abnormal gain. Three terms are very important. Try to focus on their conditions. I'll give you an example before I read out from there. I'll give you an example. I worked in some refinery where petroleum and other things are produced. Now, in refinery, there is evaporation creating normal loss. When the lid of the vessel is open, the crude oil evaporates into the air, so output is not there, it is normal loss. Let us say, I am taking some fake figures for explaining, लेट अस सी आउट ऑफ 100 लीटर इनपुट 5% एक्सपेक्टेड टू इवेपोरेट ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेसिंग बिकॉज यू विल ओपन द लिड फॉर श्योर फॉर पुटिंग मोर थिंग्स फॉर चेकिंग व्हाट इज बीइंग डन सो व्हेन यू आर डूइंग दिस 5% इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू इवेपोरेट आउटपुट एक्सपेक्टेड 95 लीटर्स वन ऑपरेटर गोज टू वर्क एंड ही इज नॉट सीरियस अबाउट हिज जॉब ही ओपन्स द लिड फॉरगेट्स ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर डे आउट ऑफ 100 लीटर इनपुट एक्चुअल वी गॉट 87 लीटर्स They should have got 95, they are getting only 87. So he has lost actually 13 liters. Actual loss. This is actual output. Should have been 5, but it is 13. 8 liters abnormal loss. 5 liter was normal, expected. Anything beyond 5 liter in 100 is unexpected or abnormal. Normal versus abnormal, very important to make a distinction because their accounting treatment is going to be totally different. On some other day, some other extraordinary careful worker is working. What he does? He opens lid very carefully. Lesser than normal time he is opening the lid. He is getting 96 liter output. What he has done? 4 liters total loss. Abnormal gain. You were expecting 5 liter loss, but he has done only 4 liter loss due to his extraordinary care and diligence. He is more careful than a normal worker. So you are getting 4 liter loss means abnormal gain is 1 liter. If this worker keeps on doing work here, 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 after a few months, 4% will become normal loss rate. Because this will become the experience of that company. But otherwise, as per present past experience, 5% was normal, 4% was actual, 1% was abnormal gain. Take another example. I worked in an embroidery company. Now, in that industry, large quantity of cloth passes through big machines on which embroidery is created. The prints are created with the help of thread, the embroidery is done. Now, while the machine is running, which runs for constant 5 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, while the production is being done, the machine requires regular oiling at specified places. When the operator puts oil there, some spots go on to the cloth which is being processed, and that becomes a loss, and it is unavoidable. After every 1 hour, 70 minutes, 80 minutes, you have to oil that machine, otherwise it will be jammed. Now this oil staining problem causes some cloth to be spoilt, which is sold as a scrap. Now in 100 meter of production, I am expecting 5 meter to be lost. On a given day, the operator is negligent enough to throw off all the oil on the cloth, and you are getting production of 80 meter. So my loss is actually 20 meter. Only 5 meter was normal. 15 meter is abnormal. On the other hand, one extraordinarily careful worker does oiling very carefully with small beak. He is not putting any oil spots on the cloth. But still, in 100 meter, he get output of 97 meter. What he has done? 3 meter loss and 2 meter abnormal gain. What he has done is 2 meter of abnormal gain. I hope these examples clarify your concept of normal loss, expected, abnormal loss, more than expected loss, abnormal gain, less than expected loss. If your percentage changes 2, 3, 4 times, then certainly your normal loss percentage will change accordingly because your past experiences are changing. This is the concept you have to take into consideration while doing process costing. Now, get back to the write-up part here. What is written here? Concentrate. When actual loss is more than normal expected loss, what you are getting? Abnormal loss. I can also write it like this. You can see here. If actual output is less than expected output, then is abnormal loss. Two things you can check, either check loss or check output. If actual output is less than expected output, there is abnormal loss because your output is less. Or if actual loss is more than normal loss, then there is abnormal loss. On the other hand, if actual loss is less than normal expected loss, there is abnormal gain. Or actual output is more than expected output, there is abnormal gain. Output more, loss less, then there is abnormal gain. Output less and loss more, then there is abnormal loss. These are the conditions which are explained for, and they are all dependent on past experience, which is telling you normal loss percentages. Now, I am showing you making of a process account. Losses will come on credit side. The gain will come on debit side. How to do their valuation is most important part of this chapter. I am going to tell you valuation of normal loss, abnormal gain in process account. How to do it? Very, very important. So, process account, you can first make it, I'll just speak it once, then I'll start elaborating it. Normally, we have 3 columns on debit side, 3 on credit side. In your institute booklet or other books, sometimes they make cost per unit column also. I will like to avoid. I'll put units column and amount column. Particulars unit rupees, particulars units rupees. 6 columns, 3 on debit, 3 on credit. On debit side, I'm putting 2 process 1. If I am making second process, from where did the material come? From first process. If it is first process, 2 process 1 will not come. If it is fourth process, I will have 2 process 3. From third process, the material has come there. Additional material to material, additional labor, to production overhead, they may be actually incurred there or may be apportioned on some ratio basis. Whatever is there, overheads will also come. Material labor overheads and material which is received from previous process, if any. On credit side, by normal loss, by abnormal loss, on debit side to abnormal gain, abnormal loss and gain cannot coexist in a single process. In a single question, you can have abnormal loss, abnormal gain in different processes. बट सेम प्रोसेस यू कांट हैव बोथ द थिंग्स एबनॉर्मल गेन ऑल्सो एबनॉर्मल लॉस ऑल्सो. नॉर्मल लॉस कैन ऑलवेज बी देयर, नॉर्मल लॉस विल ऑलवेज बी देयर. अलॉन्ग विद दैट आइदर एबनॉर्मल गेन और एबनॉर्मल लॉस कैन कम. देन बैलेंसिंग फिगर बाय प्रोसेस थ्री इफ देयर इज एनी, इफ इट इज लास्ट प्रोसेस बाय फिनिश गुड्स स्टॉक, बाय एफजी स्टॉक, फिनिश गुड स्टॉक यू विल बी हैविंग. नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस केयरफुली, अलॉन्ग विद मी ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस केयरफुली. टू प्रोसेस वन, इफ देयर इज मटीरियल कमिंग फ्रॉम प्रीवियस प्रोसेस दैट विल कम हियर. यूनिट्स विल कम, यस. रुपीज वट एवर वॉज ऑन क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ प्रोसेस वन विल बी ऑन डेबिट साइड ऑफ दिस प्रोसेस. मटीरियल यूनिट्स कैन बी देयर, एडिशनल मटीरियल विच इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन दिस प्रोसेस अलॉन्ग विद अमाउंट. लेबर यूनिट्स यू डोंट हैव टू पुट क्रॉस देयर, यू डोंट हैव टू राइट एनीथिंग देयर, डैश यू कैन पुट. अमाउंट विल बी देयर ऑन एक्रूअल बेसिस. प्रोडक्शन ओवर हेड कैन बी एक्चुअल इनकर्ड और कैन बी अ पोर्शन बेसिस. वट एवर प्रोडक्शन ओवर हेड इज देयर विल कम. ऑन क्रेडिट साइड बाय नॉर्मल लॉस यूनिट्स विल बी परसेंटेज ऑन इनपुट यूनिट्स. इनपुट यूनिट विच इनपुट, प्रोसेस वन रिसीव्ड एंड मटीरियल एडिशनली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, 5% 10% वट एवर इज एक्सपेक्टेड परसेंटेज विल कम देयर. Now, important thing to follow is this. Scrap, if any. Scrap, if any. For normal loss, there is no valuation done except putting the scrap value, if any. Question might give you scrap. In my second example, embroidery cloth. It can be sold as scrap. Yes, whether it is normal loss or abnormal loss does not matter. It can be sold. Then scrap value of normal loss will come here. In my first example, evaporation of crude oil, there is no scrap value. Scrap cannot come. It evaporates. So how can you get any money from that evaporation? So it will be zero here. Not quantity I am saying amount will be zero in first example. In second example, when you are able to sell the scrap, scrap value of normal loss units will come here. Question arises, what about scrap of abnormal scrap units? Can abnormal loss be sold as scrap? Answer is yes. Will that scrap come in process account? Answer is no. Very important. Is abnormal loss also saleable? Yes. Will you take that scrap value in process account? Answer is no. Big no. That is why normal and abnormal should be made distinct. They should not be confused. They should be kept separate. Now, if I put finished output or units taken to next process, if they are sold by cost of sale, units will come here. We are going to put it at something called valued cost. Abnormal loss, there are three ways to compute the units of abnormal loss. Three ways, I am saying again. One way, compare actual output and expected output. Actual output and expected output. If actual output is lesser, abnormal loss units. Actual output is more than expected output, abnormal gain units. One way to compute. Number two, compare normal loss and actual loss. If actual loss is higher than normal loss, abnormal loss. If actual loss is lesser than normal loss, abnormal gain. Third way to compute is easiest. Balancing figure in the units column. Balancing figure in the units column after putting the finished output. If balancing figure is on credit side, abnormal loss. If on debit side, it is abnormal gain. So this you can get from any of the three ways that I have told you. This is also at valued cost. If it is on this side, this is also at valued cost. So remember throughout the topic, in process accounts, three things maximum are to be at valued cost: completed units, abnormal loss or abnormal gain. Loss or gain, one will be applicable. Whichever is there will be at valued cost. Question arises, how to compute the valued cost? There is a formula written here. How to compute this valued cost? This is again very important. Valued cost per unit. This is an important learning of the day. From debit side, get total cost. From debit side, add process one, material, labor, overhead, whichever is applicable, add them, total cost. Subtract scrap value of normal loss. As I show you here, this is added. From there, you subtract this scrap value of normal loss. Concentrate on this. The word is normal loss. Scrap value of abnormal loss is not deducted here. Whole divide by expected output units. What is expected output? It is input units minus normal loss units. Input units minus normal loss units. This is now, very importantly, once you get valued cost per unit multiplied by units of output, abnormal loss, abnormal gain, put in the process account and compulsorily, process account will tally on its own, no balancing figure. If there is any difference in debit and credit side amount columns, you have done some blunder, you need to check. So, process account sitting in exam, you will find that it is a tallied account. You will not have any difference in the amount column. If you have forgotten something, you have done some wrong approximation, then there can be a difference. Otherwise, there will be no difference at all. Maybe one paisa difference here and there, you can adjust. And don't approximate valued cost per unit. Take it till the end on your calculator. Then process account will surely tally on its own. This is a process account you are going to make in this chapter many times. So, very, very important to follow the same. So, next what we discuss is accounting for losses and gains. What I am going to elaborate, all the journal entries which relate to abnormal loss, abnormal gain, normal loss. We are going to reach a ledger account also. Ledger accounts of abnormal gain, abnormal loss and normal loss. So, try to get all the concepts clear here so that you can understand questions later on. What I explained earlier, how do you identify abnormal gain or abnormal loss? I start with an example of abnormal gain because important and difficult is entries related to abnormal gain. So, try to understand carefully. Take an example. Actual input to the process is 1000 kg. Actual input 1000 kg. And I am expecting normal loss 10%. Normal loss is predetermined based on past experiences. My previous experiences say it will be 10%. Okay. So, I am expecting out of 1000 kg, 100 kg to loss, normal loss. And I am expecting output of 900 kg. Expecting output of 900 kg. By chance, when I check, my actual output is 920 kg. Is this good or bad? I am getting more output. If I am getting more output, it is abnormal gain. Or you check the loss. Your actual loss is only 80 kg. Out of 1000, you are getting 920. So, actual loss is only 80 kg. Should have been 100, but it is 80. Loss is less. So, it is abnormal gain. So, whatever angle you check, there is abnormal gain of 20 kg. Let us say scrap rate is 2 rupees per kg. इट इज लाइक एम्ब्रॉयडरी एग्जाम्पल, देर इट वॉज मीटर, हेयर इट इज केजी. नाउ आई वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग अ लॉस ऑफ 100 kg. आई वॉज प्रिपेयर टू गेट फ्रॉम स्क्रैप डीलर 200 rupees, बट एक्चुअली विल ही पे मी 200 rupees? नो, एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट हैविंग 100 kg एट ऑल, आई एम हैविंग 80 kg ओनली. सो ही विल पे मी ओनली 160. Why did I not get 40? Due to abnormal gain. So abnormal gain account has to get the treatment of those 40 rupees. I hope context is clear. 1000 kg input, 10% normal loss expected, expected output 900, expected loss 100. Actually I got 920, 20 extra is abnormal gain because loss was 80 instead of 100. And scrap value per kg is 2 rupees. Now in this context, I am going to make you understand the journal entries. First entry comes from process account. You have already made a process account. In process account on debit side, abnormal gain was there. So entry comes from there. Related to abnormal gain will do first. Sorry. Recording in process account. Process account debited to abnormal gain account. So abnormal gain, first entry comes from process account on debit side. Process account debited to abnormal gain at what cost? Valued cost. There I taught you it will come at valued cost. We compute their valued cost per unit multiplied by units, that value will come. Now very important, there is special entry for adjustment. This is most important part of this session. I put by normal loss in process account. I am saying by normal loss, how many kg in my example? 100 kg. What you are expecting? 100 kg. And what is the value you are going to put against it? 100 into 2, 200 rupees in process account. But will you get those 200 rupees? Scrap dealer will give me only 160 rupees. Normal loss is overvalued by 40. I need to reverse it. Normal loss credited in my example with rupees 40. Due to what you are doing this? Due to abnormal gain. So debit that. Abnormal gain to normal loss, rupees 40 is most important entry to remember. Most important entry to remember. I explain again once more. In process account, my example, by normal loss is 100 kg. It is not 80 kg. It is 100 kg. Because expected normal loss was 100 kg. I want to put amount against it. 2 rupees per kg on 100. 200 rupees. So technically normal loss is standing at 200. It is overvalued. My scrap dealer will not give me 200. He will give me 160. So I need to improve it. I need to put normal loss back. So credit normal loss 40 rupees. And debit what? Abnormal gain. Due to abnormal gain we are getting this. Student says, sir, put there only 160. But then valued cost will be wrong. So do as directed. Don't do the innovations. You can't put 160 or 80 kg in that process account. In process account, it remains 100 and 200. Here, we are reversing the 40. Due to abnormal gain, debit abnormal gain. This will affect two accounts. Abnormal gain on debit side, normal loss on credit side. I hope this much is clear. Third entry. Balancing figure in abnormal gain account should be taken to costing P&L. All abnormal items are always taken to costing P&L account. So, same here. The abnormal gain account is closed by टेकिंग इट्स बैलेंसिंग फिगर टू कॉस्टिंग पी एंड एल अकाउंट. दिस इज बैलेंसिंग फिगर ऑफ एबनॉर्मल गेन अकाउंट. आई एम शोइंग इट्स लेजर ऑल्सो. यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दिस लेजर एंड वेन एवर एबनॉर्मल गेन अकाउंट इज आस्ट यू आर गोइंग टू रिपीट दीज थिंग्स श्योरली इन दैट. रुपीज 40 आई हैव टोल्ड यू हाउ डिड आई कंप्यूट. इट इज एबनॉर्मल गेन यूनिट्स इंटू स्क्रैप वैल्यू पर यूनिट. एबनॉर्मल गेन यूनिट्स इंटू स्क्रैप वैल्यू पर यूनिट ऑफ नॉर्मल लॉस. दैट विल बी द 40 रुपीज इन माई एग्जाम्पल. एबनॉर्मल गेन लेजर अकाउंट लुक्स लाइक दिस. टू नॉर्मल लॉस, टू कॉस्टिंग पी एंड एल बाय प्रोसेस अकाउंट. दिस इज एंट्री नंबर 1, दिस इज एंट्री नंबर 2, दिस इज एंट्री नंबर 3. द डिफिकल्ट पार्ट आई हैव कवर्ड. डिफिकल्ट पार्ट इज एबनॉर्मल गेन. दैट इज वॉट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू ऑलरेडी. वेन क्वेश्चन विल कम यू विल अंडरस्टैंड मोर, बट स्टिल कीप द बेस रेडी फॉर यू. दिस इज डीलिंग ऑफ एबनॉर्मल गेन. नाउ इजियर ट्रीटमेंट एबनॉर्मल लॉस. फर्स्ट थिंग, दिस इज फॉर एबनॉर्मल लॉस. रिकॉर्डिंग इन प्रोसेस अकाउंट. इट कम्स फ्रॉम प्रोसेस अकाउंट अगेन एट वैल्यूड कॉस्ट. इट वॉज ऑन क्रेडिट साइड. एबनॉर्मल लॉस अकाउंट डेप्टेड टू प्रोसेस अकाउंट. सो एंट्री हैज बीन पोस्टेड और जनरलाइज्ड फ्रॉम देयर ओनली. एबनॉर्मल लॉस अकाउंट डेप्टेड टू प्रोसेस अकाउंट. Now, this abnormal loss units will be sold as scrap. Their scrap value never came in process account. It will come here. Scrap value of abnormal loss. Entry is bank to abnormal loss. Balancing figure in abnormal loss account will be taken to costing P&L. So, it will be close abnormal loss account, costing P&L debited to abnormal loss. Three entries everywhere. In abnormal gain, take from process, adjustment entry, balance taken to costing P&L. In abnormal loss, comes from process account, scrap abnormal loss sold, balance figure taken to costing P&L. Lastly, normal loss. This is the ledger account you can see. Abnormal loss account, to process, by bank, by costing P&L. In a sequence, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. They are posted from general to ledger. You should be clear about meaning of losses and gains. You should be clear about their journal. You should be clear about their ledger. Then basics of process costing are complete and very easily will be able to do the questions later on. Normal loss I am reaching. First is recording in process account. In process account, it is recorded at what value? Scrap value of expected normal loss units. In my example, it was 100 into 2, 200 rupees. Then comes adjustment entry only if there was abnormal gain. The same adjustment entry which we did earlier, it will have impact on normal loss account also. You don't have to create another journal entry, same journal entry having impact on ledger of this. Abnormal gain to normal loss. What was the amount there? Abnormal gain units multiplied by scrap value per unit of normal loss. This will come. Then in normal loss, costing P&L account does not come. The balance will be realized. In my example, I get back to the example. This was for rupees 200. This was for rupees 40. What about 160? 160 scrap dealer will give me in cash. So this is rupees 160. So normal loss is always realized in cash. abnormal loss balancing figure taken to costing P&L, abnormal gain balancing figure taken to costing P&L, normal loss balancing figure is realized in cash. This is the ledger account. Two process, number one, buy abnormal gain, number two, if there is abnormal loss, adjustment entry will not come. Adjustment entry will not come if there is abnormal loss. There will have normal loss to process and buy bank, same amount will be received from outside. This is complete accounting for losses and gains in process accounts.